Close your eyes for a minute and just imagine that you are in an enemy country. You are in a jail. Your hands have been tied. You are being kicked and punched. And you have been made to stand against a wall. And then somebody fires a stain gun, full magazine, onto you. Please, gentlemen and ladies, open your eyes. That's what happened to me. I am Captain G.R. Choudhary. I was commissioned in the 3rd 9 Gorkha Rifles in 1971. The battalion was part of the 87th Infantry Brigade, which was deployed on the Shakargarh bulge, which protrudes into the Jammu and Kashmir area of state of our union, across Narot, Kathua, and Madhopur. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1971 war started on 3rd of December at about 17:45 hours when the Pakistani troops crossed the international border and attacked India by air and by land. In the initial stages, we repulsed the attacks and secured our own positions and threw back the enemy. While on the 6th December 1971, we crossed the international boundary and entered Pakistan. After mopping up the forward posts inside Pakistan and securing our positions along all the posts which were within the vicinity of our international border between 1 to 3 kilometers. On 10th, 11th, and 12th, 13th, we attacked in successive night attacks village Bhatti and village Shapur, which was on the eastern side of River Bain across Shakargarh, which was quite inside Pakistan. We secured both these places in night attack and defeated the enemy companies and the battalions which were manning them. Friends, after that, on the night of 14-15, we attacked village Chatarana, which was across the River Bain, which had a riverbed of about a kilometer in freezing temperatures. We crossed the river and attacked the Pakistani positions beyond the river on the outskirts of Shakargarh and captured the objective of Chatarana. Friends, although we were able to secure the positions there, but we were heavily outnumbered and under tank and artillery fire. Half my platoon was killed and the other half was wounded in action. The orders to withdraw were issued. However, it was too late for us to be in the vanguard to withdraw, although part of the battalion withdrew. Wounded in action, bleeding profusely, I fell unconscious. When I regained consciousness, friends, what I was facing was the bayonets of enemy soldiers with their bayonets right on my face and with their eyes so angry that I immediately came to know that I am not with my own battalion. The ordeal just began. Ladies and gentlemen, interrogation and third degree treatment continued for about a day or two. After that, I was moved to Rawalpindi jail. Here again, I was there for a day or two. They kept on interrogating us, giving third degree treatment, putting us in solitary confinements, very stout men coming from behind and uncaring for my wounds or bleeding and open wounds, they will hold the neck in their strong hands and ask us questions which I didn't have any answers to. After a day or two, I was moved to the Rawalpindi hospital, military hospital. However, my wounds were attended only after a week. There, when we were taken to the operation theater, the doctor who was supposed to operate me held the surgical knife in his hand. And questioned me, why shouldn't I kill you? Why should I, you know, get you cured and put those stitches on your this thing? I had no choice but to just stare at him. After the perfunctory operation on my face and on my head, we were moved to the hospital and from there on to another jail by the name of Lailpur Fort, which is the famous or infamous jail where even Zulfikar Ali Bhutto was interned just about a week before we were moved there, because he had by then replaced Yahya Khan as the president of that country. Friends, in the meanwhile, my bedroll had been sent to my parents saying that your son had been wounded in action. Please pardon me. And he is no more. He is killed, missing in action. However, my father held forth and believed that no, even if you all, villagers, the relatives, the friends, and all of them who came to offer condolences, he refused to carry out my last rites. Please pardon me. My mother held forth amongst the ladies of the village and telling them that agar ye baat sach bhi hai, that my son is no more, still I will send my other four sons to fight for the country. Pardon me, ladies and gentlemen. You know that with the creation of Bangladesh, the two-nation theory had been busted. We, as a responsible nation, handed over the reins of that country on 16th December 1971 to the rightful elected leaders of that country. Similarly, after the Pakistan war, on the Western Front, we had captured a large territory. Although the prisoners, about a lakh of them from Bangladesh, the Shimla Agreement had been agreed, but because Mr. Bhutto came this side and asked for repatriation of the people, theirs were about 2,000 and we were about 515. Out of that, all of us who were captured either on the last day of the attack and some of us when they surprised us by that attack on 3rd of December. So all these 2,000 odd people from the Pakistani army and about 515 of ours, most of them BSF and rest of them like the infantry officers and men from our side who had attacked and captured those positions deep inside Pakistan. But despite all the third degree treatment, despite all the animosity and the things which I faced as a prisoner of war, there were certain incidents which I would like to relate and narrate it to you. While I was there in the Rawalpindi hospital, one Baluch JCO, he just came one day very quietly, because for them to talk to Indians was a very, you know, it was seen as absolutely unreligious. So the fellow will come to me and then he said, Saab, aap agar wapis Hindustan jate hain, to will you be kind enough to send me miniature copies of Ramayana and Gita? मैंने कहा साहब आप क्या करेंगे उससे, व्हाट विल यू डू? दिस जेंटलमैन टेल्स मी के साहब आई विल शो दीज टू माई ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन दैट दिस इज द कॉमन हेरिटेज. ऑन अनदर ओकेजन अ पाकिस्तानी मेजर बाय द नेम ऑफ मिस्टर जमानी, अगेन पठान ऑफिसर हु वॉज रिकॉल्ड बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ देयर ऑफिसर्स हैड बीन कैप्चर्ड हियर इन बांग्लादेश एंड दिस जेंटलमैन वॉज वेरी old and retired, but he came and we were in Lailpur fort. He was guarding us. Again, he will also once in a while just see that nobody is watching and he'll come and talk to us. And he will say, yaar, kya din the? I was posted in Madras. I was posted there in Patna, Delhi, and what a country it was. If I was on leave, suppose I came from Dhaka, it took me 7 days to reach Peshawar. But here, I'm posted in Karachi. I start at 12 o'clock and 4 o'clock I am there. I don't know why the country was partitioned. In the similar way, I overheard Pakistani jawans and JCOs talking about their crops back home. The months of monsoon, Ashad, Shravan, Bhadrapad, Amavasya, Gyaras, Poonam, when they were discussing about crops. Similarly, when we had captured that village of Batti and the Shapur village before attacking on Chatarana on the eastern side of River Bain, there was a lady in her 30s who was hiding in a home, and when we captured that village Shapur, we caught her and took her to our battalion headquarters. When we took her there, we gave her a cup of tea, we treated her well. She started crying and said that aap log itna mere saath acha ye kar rahe ho, if I was in the hands of my own army, I would have been molested by now by each and everyone. There were JCOs and officers from that army who will come sometimes when they had good mood and they will say, Saab, hum haar gaye hain, but if we were led by the Indian army officers, we wouldn't have lost the war. In the Indian army, ladies and gentlemen, the officers lead. We lead our men in battle, and that is the difference between a winning army. Our army and our armed forces are one of the best. They're second to none. Many armies of the world can lay claim to being the best, but if there is any finest fighting machine, it is the Indian armed forces. A stint in the Indian armed forces makes men out of boys. We are taught discipline, principles, and honesty are ingrained in our men and officers. Similarly, if we talk about patriotism from my point of view, I can tell you that yes, the Faujis are patriots, they sweat, give their sweat and blood on the borders, but in my view, all of us, whether we are teachers, students, farmers, laborers, workers, office goers, and in whatever profession and field we are, if we are honestly and with commitment and with devotion and with patriotism, if we are working for the country and for our own office or the work or whatever we are doing, we are all patriots. And friends, what are we? Me, my friends who were fighting on the front, or even today's time, whatever strikes are taking place and we are trying to defend our, and we are always there to defend our country. What are we without all of you, all of us, and the whole country? So everyone makes a difference and contributes in nation building. I can tell you, when I was in the academy before passing out and before going on the front, we could feel the victory in the air. Everyone was, the political leadership of 1971, the military leadership of that time. And there was, in the air, the victory was there because we were on the right path. They were committing atrocities on their own countrymen, whereas we were fighting for principles and for noble cause. The nobility took us for victory. We went with a positive attitude. We went with a triumphant approach. And we won that war. And Bangladesh was created. Within a week or 2 weeks, the whole country was created. We handed over the reins to those people, and similarly we handed over the territory which we had won after the agreement to them. Gentlemen and ladies, I remember the torture and the other things, but most what I remember about this is that when I came back, I was given a tumultuous welcome, not only at the border, but when I went to my village, the entire sea of humanity from about 50 villages from around my area came, and they all wished that they also had a son like me. Thanks a lot.